Hello, hello, everybody. It's 11:04 p.m. Central Time on the 11th of January, 2024. Hope you're doing well. We are here on the earthquake live stream just to talk about a few of the earthquakes which have struck over the past few days. I'd like to bring you up to speed on what has happened. Of course, we issued our forecast 10 days ago now, and the forecast 7 to 10 days. Of course, the one-week forecast is what we call it. If you're not aware of that, you can go over to my YouTube channel and check 9 to 10 days ago. You will find the forecast that called for a few events to happen. We were looking for a 6.5 to strike north of the big earthquake in Japan up north, and we were looking for a 6.5 to strike to the south. Additionally, we were looking for up to 7.0 level activity to strike from the border of Nepal into the Hindu Kush region right at the tip of the arrow. And as you can see, 6.4 to 6.5 earthquake struck there today, or well, yesterday now, international time. And then going back over the last day and a half, 2 days, we got a 6.2, 5.9 USGS, 6.2 from the Russians, 6.0 level from the Japanese, striking right here north of the area in Japan that broke last week. So the area that struck was about 50 to maybe 100 miles to the north of the big earthquake from last week. That fulfills the spot we were looking at. We were looking possibly as far north as the spot where Japan meets into Hokkaido, the main island of Japan into Hokkaido, as far north as there, and pretty much right back down to the 7.5 is where we were looking for it to start. So it did strike to the north. There it is right there. And that was up to 6.2. Again, we were looking for up to 6.5 on the north side. Now, the south side's a little bit different. On the south side, we were looking for a 6.5 to strike in the Ryukyu Islands. Now, this is 700 to 800, depending if you go around the bend of the plate or if you just draw a straight line between them. 700 to 800 miles south, we got a 6.7 to 7.0 earthquake. I was looking for it to here, and instead it struck down south in the Philippines, back where the break happened 2-3 weeks ago. Was it a month ago? Huge earthquake struck down in Philippines like a month ago, and that's where this new earthquake struck right next to. It's not at the exact same spot. But so, let's just recap. On the north side, we got a 6.2. On the south side, we got a 6.7 to 7.0. All the way over west, we warned from the border of Nepal at North India, right here, following the red arrow, up to the tip of the arrow in the Hindu Kush. And it struck at the tip of the arrow, so it struck on the west side of what we were looking for to strike. Now, let me show you all these arrows out of here. Let's get the arrows out of there and show it on the USGS map, the spots which moved. The north side, right up here in Japan, north of the spot that broke previously. Again, we had our big earthquakes and going all the way down to the nuclear plant down there, right along the coast, and going back up to the red line. So, new earthquake there. Then, we have to go all the way past my warned area here and go due south. There it is. So, it's on the same plate boundary. It's just due south, 700 miles. You can see here's our key down here in the lower corner. So, if I'm warning like next to Okinawa and instead we go 200, 400, 600, like 700 to 800 miles down here is where it struck. This whole plate moved on this side. Now, what happened on the other side? Why did it not strike where I was looking? Let's get back over and take a look. Look what else hit. Again, we're looking over here, and instead it strikes down here on the southwest side. On the east side, over from Guam all the way up into the Izu Ridge itself, multiple fives. If you take them in all and add them together, it equals about a 5.9's worth of energy, about a 6, striking on the east side over here. So let's recap. North side, south side, east side. The only spot that has not broken yet is the spot from Okinawa down to Taiwan. And if it goes in the next few days, I won't be surprised. I'm not issuing a forecast for that now. I'm just bringing you up to speed on what has hit based upon the forecast that we were looking for. Again, I issued the forecast 10 days ago, 7 to 10 days. Okay, let's back this out and just look at the USGS plate boundary map overall. These red lines indicate spots between plates or the plate boundaries where one plate meets against the other. The spot that's moving all the way over to the west over here is on the northwest edge of the Indo-Australian plate. So, what's happened since? Over to the west, just in the past hour, a new 5 has struck down here at the plate boundary in Greece. Energy is flowing across Europe to the south on the south side of the plate boundary. I'm also going to expect 4.0 level activity to go around the outside edge of Romania and Ukraine. Should see an earthquake pop off right on the east side of Romania. also should see additional activity in Poland, southwest Poland. And this could go up to 5.0 level activity. If we're dealing with 5 down to the south, let me show you over on the map here. Let's get all the earthquakes out of there just so you can see what I'm talking about. Here's our new 5. And you see we have 3 sets of arrows going around, well, really 2, but 1 comes in from the south and then 2 going around the edges of Europe. So around the outside edge, Romania, Ukraine, Poland. And then you also see Italy. Let's go back over to the USGS map. Look what's in Italy. The plate boundary goes right up and dead ends into North Italy. So we have 5.0 energy here, should divide. We should see upper 4 to near 5.0 level go around the outside edge of Europe, dropping off 2 sets of quakes, Romania and Poland. We should also see near 5.0 level activity go up into Italy. So for many weeks now, or many even months, we haven't seen anything huge in Italy, and that's good. We have the, of course, ongoing situation at Campi Flegri with the supervolcano there. And that's down in southwest Italy, right along the coast here at the Tyrrhenian Sea, here by the Red Arrow. But we're going to look up here. So north central Italy, this goes just next to Florence, east of Florence or south of Venice. And let's just get back over onto the USGS map and zoom in and show you right in here. Okay, so we're going to look for near 5.0 level activity to strike there as well. So it should be 3 sets of 4s or near 4 5s going around the outside edge of Europe and up into Italy. This gets me all the way out here to Iceland. So first of all, guys, if you aren't aware of what's been going on in Iceland, I would recommend that you go over and watch On the Pulse with Silky. She's been doing updates regarding Iceland. I will put a link down below to go check out her channel. We've never spoken except for maybe in a comment down below a video. So I don't know her personally, but she's doing good updates. She's staying on top of the situation and on top of the authorities, which is important when there's something like this going on. It's good to hear a citizen's perspective on things. So go check it out. Now, people were asking me about my arrows at versus what she's showing in her videos and why my arrows are pointing in a different direction than what her arrows are showing in her videos. A lot of questions about it. Let me just quickly explain. In Silky's videos, she's showing the plate tectonics, the way the plates spread and move, and my arrows are showing the way the earthquakes go, which are entirely different than the way the plates move, believe it or not. It's actually opposite. So the plates down below are moving one way, the earthquakes are moving another. Think of your phone vibrating across the tabletop and the actual vibration itself is moving one way while the phone's moving the other. That's the way things work with standing waves and vibrating waves. So it usually pushes it in the opposite direction. Well, the wave is flowing in the opposite, the seismic wave is flowing in the opposite direction. So what's going on is the Mid-Atlantic Ridge is spreading. And GPS tells us that, GPS surface measurements tell us that these two areas are spreading apart. And you can also, like she said in her videos, you can go swim between the spots where the plates are spreading in many spots in Iceland where the plate is, again, like tearing apart or pushing apart. But the seismic wave starts all the way over on the opposite side of the planet. Over here, down below the Indo-Australian plate, comes hammering in on the underside of the plate. Then it spreads out. The wave comes up through the plate and spreads out, following a path of least resistance. And the plate boundaries are a path of least resistance compared to the solid plates next to them. And the wave spreads over the whole planet over the course of days, over the course of about a week or up to 7 to 10 days. As the wave spreads, it drops off earthquakes somewhat equidistantly spaced all the way along the way, and they're all about the same size as the wave spreads out. It's like a ripple in a lake spreading out, but it's not losing much energy as it spreads out across such a vast area. It's very low frequency, ultra low frequency down in the plate that's spreading out. And then as the wave spreads, it follows these red lines, the plate boundaries, drops off the quakes along the way, and we get to Iceland where the wave impacts into Iceland, the seismic wave. Even though the plate itself is tearing apart and going one way or the other, spreading apart, the wave itself comes hammering in and it reverberates back and forth into what's called a standing wave. When one wave reflects off a wall and reflects back into another wave and then another wave comes in and you keep pushing energy in, it can build in energy and the wave height or the amplitude, or well, you could just consider it the magnitude, the power of the wave increases in a standing wave as it reflects off itself back into itself. So the wave is coming from over here. It spreads up to Japan, over to the United States. It spreads out over across the Mideast, across over into South Europe, goes around Europe, and dead ends into the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. It's like a giant wall that reflects that wave back into itself. Now, in the process of reflecting back into itself, it gets absorbed, the wave, the seismic wave, and it comes back out within days on the antipode, on the opposite side of the planet. We start seeing new hammering, new deep earthquakes. If the push is big enough, it goes all the way around, bounces back and forth here, drops off a bunch of quakes along the way. Now, standing waves principles then take place, and you can find the halfway points between the two sets of quakes here, for instance, and a new earthquake will pop off at the rough halfway point between here and here over the next few days, just as one example of many. How big is it going to be? The quake that strikes between our sets of current quakes should be about the same size that's going around the outside edge of Europe. So if we have fives going around the outside edge of Europe, going to be dropping off fours all the way along the way, and it's going to re-pool back up out here on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, should see some fives out here. And not just anywhere, where our two sets of rings overlap, on the north side of Iceland and on the south side of Iceland. Let's take a look at the previous earthquakes, if we even still have them on there. We don't. But back down south on the Reykjanes Ridge, I don't know how to pronounce that, but down here to the south, a bunch of earthquakes popped off this week. They're just not on the feed for the USGS, but right down about here. So if you were to find the halfway point between here and here, where does that put us? It puts us back down in the south part of Iceland. So as the new wave comes hammering in, we should see a new five pop off over here in South Iceland and or to the south in the ocean, hopefully. But if it strikes on land, that'll get people's attention. If it strikes down south, people seem to ignore it. However, that will be the sign that the new pressure motion is coming in. Even the scientists in Iceland say they don't know where these surges of pressure come from that push it up, out, and away. Well, let me tell you, there is a seismic wave, very low frequency, ultra low frequency. I think if we put antennas in the ground, we would actually be able to detect the electrical pulses that are coming through the plate, Mother Nature, before this happens, before the break, before the earthquake. What kind of antenna would we need to put in the ground? Something about the size of a pallet. Shipping pallet. So wooden shipping pallet size that you could put down into the ground to detect this. A guy already made one, and long story on that. So let's get back to it. Seismic wave spreading out across the planet, going in one direction, all the way over to Europe, and going in the other direction, over towards South America. Take a look at the earthquakes over the past several days. Same size, going across in the other direction. Exact same size. And where the arrows point, let me get the smaller earthquakes out of there. The cumulative total pulled up in the middle. So if you took these fives that were coming across, add them together, 5.2, 5.0, and a 5.1 equals 5.4. And what's out up ahead of it? 5.4. There it is. Now the rest are fives and 4.6s. Make note of 5 and 4.6 because that's what we're talking about on the opposite side of the plate. But on this side, it's spread out. The standing wave has spread out this way, across, and look what's over on the east side. The Nazca and Cocos plates. And you can see the dividing line between them here on the north side and here on the south side. And the earthquakes are following both on the north side and on the south side. Once it impacts, the wave impacts into South America and Central America, just like you would expect a wave to spread out and across a surface of a shoreline. The same thing happens over a vast distance, and we get the same size quakes spread out across the whole mass, all the way down south, all the way up north. This is over the last 6 days. Here's the last 2 days. Same thing applies. Like bookends, 4.6 and a 4.8 on the south side, 4.6 and a 4.8 on the north side. The 4.8 was downgraded to 4.3, doesn't matter. Go back a day. There you go. So it spread out to the south. Now, on the north side, let's talk about the north side. Coming out of Japan, we got our 6-point-something earthquake on the north side of the 7 in Japan. Same time, 4.6 to 4.7, again, and a 4.8, again, going across all the way over to another 4.3 that was originally a 4.8 as well.